Barrett's esophagus is a condition that affects the bottom of the gullet or esophagus. It's a change in the lining of the esophagus from the normal pale colour or skin-like lining to a salmon pink lining. And essentially the cells are replaced by cells that are very typical of the cells in the stomach or intestine and differ from the cells lining the esophagus. The most important aspect of Barrett's esophagus is that in some people, a minority of those with Barrett's, there's an increased risk of esophageal cancer. About 40% of people who have Barrett's esophagus don't have any symptoms. And we think this is because Barrett's is an adaptive response to acid reflux. And once it's developed, there's very little inflammation to cause pain. However, 60% of patients with Barrett's have symptoms typical of acid reflux. And these include heartburn, chest pain, regurgitation of food and fluid, particularly at night when you lie down, and recurrent belching. Occasionally, patients with Barrett's do experience difficulty in swallowing. However, that's unusual and should be considered as a symptom of concern and will usually require investigations such as an endoscopy. The main cause of Barrett's esophagus is reflux of acid or gastroesophageal acid reflux. In fact, all patients with Barrett's have gastroesophageal reflux. Most patients with Barrett's also have a hiatus hernia, and a hiatus hernia is where part of the top of the stomach comes through the diaphragm into the chest. And this means that the anti-reflux mechanism or anti-reflux barrier is slightly impaired, allowing more acid to come up from the stomach into the esophagus. It's not due to an excess of acid, simply more acid moving from the stomach up into the chest. Those at risk include those who are overweight, those with obesity, but also those with a family history of Barrett's esophagus. Now, those with Barrett's have an increased risk of esophageal cancer, but not everyone with Barrett's gets esophageal cancer. In fact, far less than 5% of those with Barrett's esophagus. There are additional risk factors for esophageal cancer. That depends on the length of the Barrett's, so the Barrett's can be short or long, a family history of esophageal cancer, smoking, being a man, and again, obesity. The vast majority of patients with Barrett's esophagus are simply treated with anti-reflux medication. These include the proton pump inhibitors, or PPIs, and include drugs such as omeprazole or lansoprazole. Occasionally, the Barrett's cells can change. And when they do change, they can become either dysplastic or can develop early cancer. It's therefore important to keep an eye on patients with Barrett's with repeat endoscopies, and these should be done anywhere between 1, 2, 3, 4, or even 5 years, depending on the type of Barrett's and how high the risk is. Where there is a high risk of cancer development, it's important to treat those cells. And this is done with a combination of endoscopic therapy, either cutting out the abnormal cells, a procedure called endoscopic mucosal resection, or EMR, or burning the cells off with a treatment called radiofrequency ablation, or RFA, with a halo device.